Queen Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network.
One of the things I've noticed about you is that you said you traveled a lot, but you didn't have a lot of money. And I know that to be true because I've not traveled a lot, but I have done some traveling and overseas. I went overseas with $100 in my pocket.
Let me tell you what was amazing when I went to Europe. Okay. And I spent about five or six weeks there. Every time I would go places, it really taught me who I was. Mm-hmm. Because, oh, you're beautiful. You know, the guy called me Cleopatra, and I was one of those mean black women.
The guy called you Cleopatra.
He called me Cleopatra, and I said, my name is Cornelia McDonald. He said, you've been lied to. Elizabeth Taylor is not Cleopatra. Cleopatra is a black woman, and it's you. He said, you have a great trip. I said, wow, I've got to rethink myself. Had I never been a nurse, had I never moved to California, had I never traveled, I wouldn't be sitting here today to talk to you. All of that helped me to really go through the process of eliminating the cancer.
Which brings home the point that you don't always have to have the things or the people or the places or be surrounded by that which you think you need. All you have to really do is just to be still, to listen, and to show up and do what you were supposed to do.
I was in the south of France, and there was a couple. Didn't speak much English. I didn't speak French. I was going back to Paris, and they said, tell the lady to come, and she can stay with us in their chalet for the weekend, and we'll put her back on the plane, on the train Monday.
And you didn't even know these people,
mm-hmm.
but you just you got quiet, you listened because you were in the process of learning to love Cornelia, and people and things and opportunities showed up because you had been quiet.
Walked into the restaurant, and they said, it's on us. Beautiful Italian
restaurant. In another country.
How
often does that happen?
On the train, they said, oh, our American princess. They would tell me, you know, points of interest and everything. And the landscape over there is beautiful.
Tina, so much.
More from, you know, country to country is beautiful.
So much Tina Turner decided to move there.
Exactly.
And stay there.
Because we sit in the same place, want something different, and saying the same thing. And it's called insanity.
Yeah.
We do the same thing.
Because it's not going to get you.
There ain't no good black men. Mm-hmm. There no this, mm-hmm. there no that.
No jobs.
No jobs.
No.
The world is like at our fingertips
right
now. If you are not learned now,
chances are.
Guess what? Then it's a choice.
Mm-hmm.
The internet, the world comes to your door in your house.
You don't even have to leave home.
You don't have to leave home. Are you seeing how many bookstores I've been to writing? How many libraries? You have to leave home.
No, you don't.
Priorities, another thing. Let's get our priorities together.
Because you are your first priority.
When you understand the power of loving yourself, you get to dictate what's important to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, most of us buy a car, buy a house that we can't afford.
Mm-hmm.
So we can impress somebody that don't even
Girl,
like us.
Girl, you better say that.
Did you see what she had on the church? Did you see what?
We won't even go into the conversation talking about the church folks now.
But I'm not going to talk about it, but yeah. I'm saying that. Oh, girl, she didn't even have a proper dress.
Right. Did you see the hole in her pantyhose and run over shoes?
People used to say to my mom, you don't look like a preacher's wife. You don't dress like a preacher's wife.
Don't fit that mold. You don't, that stereotype.
You know, first lady. I often tell people, they get upset with me, there's a first lady. There's a two and a three behind the first.
You better know it.
So you better be clear.
Yes, ma'am.
You know that you are, you know, we used to performing. When you go out of this house, what goes on in the house is nobody's business. When you go out of this house, you better act like you got some sense.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to knock something in you. And I'm all for good manners now.
Yes, ma'am.
I really am. I'm all for kids right. being instructed in right. good manners.
Right.
But you raise chickens.
Yeah.
We have to nurture our children.
Yes, we do.
When we get in the love paradigm, it's about expanding. It's about nurturing. It's about holding ourselves accountable. Children don't do what you say anymore. They do what you do.
They do what you do. So well.
So don't. Kid told me one time I went to speak, and I said to him, "You got to start acting better. What is the problem?" I said, "You know." He said, "Well, Big Mama and the Reverend so and so and so. He came in there about 12 o'clock last night. The Big Mama, and they thought I was asleep. So." Big Mama does what she want to do. I can do what I want. He's like 10 or 11. I said, Lord have mercy.
Mm-hmm. Not what you tell them to do.
And the
what
preacher
they see
got a
you
wife.
Mm-hmm. First lady at home, being dutiful, being who she was.
A hat in a parking space.
Told to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when we tell ourselves, we become authentic. When we understand we don't have to be perfect. We have to understand love. Perfection is really something that's sinister, I think.
Perfection is a setup for disappointment because
True.
You are looking perfection from whose perspective?
Right. And what's perfect for you
may not be perfect for the next person.
Right. We have, okay, you want to read some more?
Where is it? Deep secret or grief eating away at the self. Carrying hatreds.
Yeah.
How many of us carry around hate?
Yeah.
For a very long time. I don't know if you noticed today when you first got here, we were setting the studio. One of the things that I've always carried around my own self-hatred was that of my ears. As a kid, well, I wear them now, but my head is wrapped, so they need to be because I don't want to look like Pinocchio with my ears. Sticking out, but I had a thing about my ears, mm-hmm. and I would always wear a scarf, and other body parts, such as my arms. Right. I had my arms out today, and
right.
I never leave the Sweet. House because I have big arms.
Right.
So I have always been judging myself
right.
by other people's standards. And feet, I wear a size 11. I've been lying to folks all my life, saying, girl, I wear 9.
You know,
I'm 11. You get older, your body changes. So what? You're a size bigger than you were 20 years ago. What difference does it make?
But what's more powerful than our bodies is our spirit.
Yes, ma'am.
And when we start loving on, because I have to love on me.
Yes, you do.
I have to daily, sometimes 2 or 3 times a day, because I get that, you know, that self-hatred. Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. I say, you know what, Cornelia? Stop. What is it about? Mm-hmm. I want you to go do some mirror work and love on yourself.
Oh, now that you talk about courage, that takes some courage to stand in the mirror butt naked. In your birthday suit
yeah.
and love everything you see about yourself.
I said, you know what?
That's some work.
But I'm still here, though.
Hi, I'm Rosalina Mota, and you are watching the Higher Learning Network.
And I'm David Leonard. You're watching the Higher Learning Network.
Okay, so what do you want to do about it?
Mm-hmm.
You dissatisfied with this?
Mm-hmm.
Your arms, your legs? What do you want to do about it? And I said the most wonderful thing to myself this morning. I said, you know what, Cornelia? You're still here, girl.
That's all that matters.
You're still here,
and you have a chance to do something about that which you don't like. But ask yourself the question, why is it that you don't like it?
Because
what seed has been planted?
Exactly. Exactly.
I need you to look into your camera and tell the person who's watching this show who may have some self-hatred, who is experiencing some challenges in their personal and professional life, and especially if they have a health challenge, what would you tell them?
The first thing I would say to you is this. God made you. You were born worthy. He made you from love. You come from love, you're going to go back to love. And if you're having health challenges, ask yourself why. What does this mean? Because you know what? When a car is full of gas, you don't put more gas in it. So what can I back up on? What can I say to myself? Let me just love myself. Let me get in the mirror, take all my clothes off, and stand there and turn around. And what am I going to say to myself? You know what I say to myself? You know what, Cornelia? Thank God for all those sales. Mm. Thank God that you're still here. Thank God that you can see. Because when I first had that chemo, my eyes were like blurred for at least 6 months. Mm. I didn't have a taste for like a year. Mm. Thank God for the taste in my mouth. Thank God for my feet. Thank God that I get to live another day and experience this. Because everything you're going through is going to help somebody else. Mm. Everything you're going through. None of us are islands. So you're pretending. You don't have to pretend anymore. Cancer pulls the cover off of you. Mm. It strips you naked. Because all 8 months of treatment, I was like, okay. You know, they have to do all the exams and stuff. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay.
Yeah, this is it.
This is it, you know. And my doctor, you know, was like, wow, you know, you just really take such good care of your body. Take care of your body. I saw a lady yesterday on the plane giving her daughter a diet soda.
Oh.
Not even 7 years old. So understand, okay, I ask my body every day, is this going to help me or is it going to harm me? Mm. You know, they advertise for you every day to eat a certain thing, mm-hmm. to think a certain thing. Mm-hmm. So understand that, you know what, let me go on a media diet. And you know what's going to happen? You're going to be the better for it. Mm. I hope I'm going to live a long time because I said, God, I know you got something for me to do. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to live because I'm here. Let it be known, I am here to really reach my destiny and for greatness. I don't want to be normal. I wasn't born normal.
I know that's right.
I'm 6'1".
I know that's right.
I got a booming voice. I'm going to love Cornelia till the cows come home. Mm. And if you don't like me because my thighs are fat, oh well.
Well, that's your
next
issue. Okay.
It ain't about you.
Next caller.
It's about me. So we sit there and cry about being a victim. Oh, he did this. You allowed it. When you stop allowing things and you set the standards, your life will be very different. Love yourself. Think about it. Water gives you life. People say, I can't believe your skin is so beautiful. I turned gray. I turned every color it was from that treatment. Mm. So I'm very clear.
So you were rejuvenated.
Rejuvenated, reborn.
Any kind of re you want to think about.
Everything. What did I say? Rebirth?
Yes, ma'am.
Reborn and fully loaded.
And if you can't love yourself, if there's someone in your life who loves you, Big Mama or who, spend more time with them.
Yeah.
And get that from them. So at some point in your life, you can begin to love yourself. I thank God for my husband, Tony Hoges, because he probably doesn't know this and I've never told it. So why do you tell it on national television? Is that he loves me more than I love myself.
Wow, that's sweet. Well, he knows who he is then. And let me tell you something else. I only go where I'm celebrated.
I know that's right.
Never where I'm tolerated.
Mm, can you please repeat that?
I only go where I'm celebrated. Never where I'm tolerated. And when I meet a Tony, the world. The world would be different.
Oh, Miss Cornelia, girl, we could sit here and chat for hours.
I
want to thank our crew because our crew, Charles Hot Mix Nelson, who is our director today, Charles suffered a stroke a couple of years ago. Charles couldn't do anything, but by the grace of God, he is in therapy. That's why I say I love therapy. Charles is an amazing director. He's an amazing editor, producer, and he is back. And because of Charles, you are seeing this show. He had some health challenges. A technical director from the last show when you were here, Keith McDonald, your cousin, your newfound cousin.
Oh, my newfound cousin.
Keith
yeah.
was on his way to tape an event that we were having, and he called me and said, and I couldn't show up. And the 20 years I've known him, he has never done this.
He was in the hospital. I saw him on Facebook.
He was in the hospital. Yeah. So for the fact that he didn't show up, I knew something was wrong. And Keith is now back. He is watching what he eats, and he rests because he's a workaholic. Thank you for showing up today, Keith.
He looks good.
Yes, he does look good.
I saw him last night.
Yes. And also, somebody else had a health challenge. Me, I had a health challenge. I was diagnosed with diabetes. And remember, I asked you about what did you know about not the recipe, but some things that you told me. And my sister, who is not a nutritionist, but she goes to a farm. She's a farm girl. And she gave me a recipe that I made, that I drink every day. Beets,
Wonderful.
Kale,
Wonderful.
Cucumber, lemon,
yep.
ginger,
yep.
turmeric. And I drink it every day. And a year later, I went to my doctor a month ago, and I no longer have diabetes.
You're beautiful. And I cured myself of diabetes also.
You can cure yourself.
Yeah.
You don't need a doctor to
yeah.
tell you that.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not saying don't follow the doctor's program. But in addition to...
It's the way you eat. And the most important thing is self-love.
Yes, ma'am.
When you love yourself...
part of what you eat is self-love.
Exactly. Because that's how you're nourishing yourself, right?
I want to thank you, the queen.
I want to thank you, queen number two.
For coming here and blessing us today. I want to thank you for showing up and allowing God to move, think, and have its being in, through, and around you, and to send you back to Chicago, girl. Cause
thank you.
This has been a moment I've been waiting for. Nobody knew this but me. I kept it to myself. Sometimes you just have to keep good things to yourself.
Exactly.
So thank you for showing up and showing out and for being who you are, and continued success on Hollywood, girl. And you got to invite us out there so we can come see you in Hollywood.
I would love to. And
yes,
you are
ma'am.
Absolutely beautiful.
Well, I'm only a reflection of you, my
thank
sister.
You, thank
I can't,
you,
I can't see it in you. I can't see it in you if it's not in me and vice versa.
You're beautiful.
And I want to thank you, our viewing audience of the Higher Learning Network, to remember to do something special for yourself and watch what goes in here. Watch what you put in here. Watch
what you
drink.
What you say in your mouth.
And what you say and what you think. Read some books. The book that you need to read for this month and for every other month is...
I Want to Tell You My Story.
Because we all have one. What's the name of the book again?
I Want to Tell You My Story.
By Cornelia McDonald. It's available on Facebook,
Amazon. And then you can go to Barnes & Noble. They'll order it for you.
Right. And you can also go to the Higher Learning Network because it's there as well. I want you to take the rest of this day after you turn off your television or YouTube or however you're watching it on your iPad, iPod, whatever, and just get quiet and get still and ask your God, Allah, Buddha, Yahweh, Judah, whatever you call it. Just talk to it. Just be quiet. You don't even have to say anything. Just be quiet and listen to the still, small voice that will never, ever steer you wrong.
Amen.
Stay on purpose, stay empowered, and stay tuned for more of the Higher Learning Network. And thanks for watching.
Higher Learning, just run into some things that's really like what's happening. And what's happening is this brother right here. Hey, Rob.
Hey, what's happening, Chicago?
What are you doing here at this expo today?
I'm here for the Black Women's Expo. I'm doing a seminar later on today on how to make it in the business, how to make it in show business, since I've been in it for about 100 years or so. So I might know a little something. But I'm here also promoting my mother's book, Conversations with My Mother. This is about her 80 years of faith as a Christian, coming from Mississippi, the cotton fields of Mississippi, to instill that same faith in me. If thou canst believe, all things are possible. Ask anything in his name. John 14:12 is real and true.
Yes, Lord.
So
and thank you, my brother. I didn't know you had the holiness in y'all right now. That's me in Ohio Learning, yeah. Now, we got a real good one coming up for y'all brothers at home. It's going to be a doozy. Perry and Myron, stay tuned.
Hi, this is Ernest Thomas, Mr. Omar. Mr. Omar.
Good for the bloopers.
Good
for the
bloopers. All
right, all right.
See, we all bloopers.
You going to do that?
Behind the scenes with Men on Higher Learning. So, right.
All right, all right, all right. All right, all right. Hey, this is Mr. Omar. This is Mr. Omar, y'all. What's my name again? Mr. Omar. Yeah, Mr. Omar. Hey, this is Mr. Omar, Ernest Thomas, Everybody Hates Chris Rock, What's Happening? And you're watching Men on Higher Learning. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow, look at this here. Good times. Got JJ. There's JJ, there's Mom, there's Winona. Oh, there goes Thelma. Everybody remember Thelma. There's Michael and Uncle Dad. We know who he is. But look at this picture here. Is that the same person? Wow. Well, all right. It'd be nice to meet her in person, wouldn't you say? Hey, hi, hi. Whoa, you look like, she looks like Thelma from Good Times. Could this be Thelma?
Hi, how are you?
Hi, hey Bernadette.
Hi, honey, how are you?
You know, I missed you at the African Fest. I wanted to get an interview with you, but we was busy around there, and by the time I got back, you were gone. But, what's happening with you and your book?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, of course, I have this book, Situations 101, Relationships, the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. I've been promoting that one for about 2 years. And I just came out with my new book, Situations 101, Finances, the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. And both of them are selling off the table, and it's just been good.
All right. Well, I'm going to buy your book, and I'm sure my friends are, because they want to see an interview with Thelma. So, Thelma. Could you say hello to Perry Mason and Marvin Davis?
Hi, Perry Mason and Marvin Davis. How are you? Okay, I'll see you later.
Thank you.
Publishing is a billion-dollar industry. Tell your story and make money. Videographer and chef Tony Hoag's new book, Southern Style Cooking with a Twist that Helps Diabetics, too.
A special thanks to our intern of the year, Miss Andrea Slaughter, my husband Tony's niece. Andrea, where's she at? Where's she at? Oh, she doesn't want to be on camera. And also our other producers, Zazelle, I don't know your last name, but you're a Z girl, so you all right with me. Let's give Zazelle a great big round of applause. Did I forget anybody? I forgot my hubby, Tony Ho. Thank you, baby, especially for the Higher Learning Network and the lights and all that good stuff, production, producing, and all that. Special thanks to, where is it at? Special thanks to this show being made possible by Ali Jaffer, the owner and proprietor of Rosati's Pizza on Grand and LaSalle. Good on Grand and LaSalle, as we are about to go partake in some spinach and some broccoli and some mushrooms. Yeah, so we're gonna eat good today after the show. All right, so we're being a little careful about what we put in our mouths today. Okay, I'm gonna pick the spinach out of the pizza and eat that with some water. Okay, all right, bye y'all, gotta go.
Thank you.
Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network. What you hear about?
Hello, this is Mari Rodriguez.
And Andre Bellos.
And we were Background 4.
Empire. You can find Mari at
Mari Rubia, MariRuviaA, or Twitter, Mari L. Rodriguez.
Check me out on my website, AndreBellos.com, and you are tuned into the Higher Learning Network.
Hello!
What's your name?
Jane.
Jane, you are so pretty, girl.
Thank
Make
you.
Us four-finger sisters look good.
So why are you here today? What brought you here?
Actually, I come out here a lot for book signings, but okay. I really liked her book. I read it. It was encouraging and whatever.
You read it already?
Yeah,
oh,
I got
goodness.
It a few weeks ago. So.
Okay. Have you read Shalom's books, Inspirational Conversations, 365 Days from Promise? Comes on Troy Tyler every day at 10:45.
Was Elder Robinson?
Yeah,
I sure have.
That?
Yeah, it's
good
on my bookshelf. Yeah.
Is it really? Where'd you get it from?
Afrocentric.
Good for you. I'm going to introduce you to her when we get in here, okay?
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
So let's come on in. We're going in the book.
We're going to see Monique. Us big girls, you know, we got our own fan club.
By the way, have you ever met Zelda? Do you know who she is?
No, I've never met her.
You're talking to her.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Are you just for a special conversation with
Zelda? Yeah, you see, I got my book, girl.
Let me get a shake of hand.
Hey,
come on, sister.
Okay. We're going to have some fun,
okay.
Girl. You know,
and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network.